Really nervous, very excited that the movie is releasing tomorrow. I'm back in Tollywood exactly after, I think, about 8-9 months. Gunde Jari was, as you all know, it was a really, really big hit and it did 100 days. So thank you for the support on that movie, and I'm really happy to be here again. I hope I do lots of more Telugu movies. Maine Pyar Kiya, I'm happy, thank you to the director that he's got me back in Tollywood with this film. I had a lot of offers after Gunde Jari, but nothing that I really wanted to take up, which is why I've been missing in action for so long. About the film, this film is basically, it's a rom-com, and it's about childhood friends who sort of discover love, but they've lost touch and they meet after years, and how they sort of rebuild their relationship, and the confusions that sort of take place because of the gap that they've, you know, they haven't met for so many years, and how you grow up to be different people. So that's what more or less the film is about. And there's a parallel love story with Satya and Madhumita. That's a more pure traditional love story. This one is a more like how the youth is today, you know, how we're all constantly WhatsApping and we're on social networking. So it's more of an SMS relationship this time, not literally, but that's the rapport that we have. And it's an entertainer, and it releases tomorrow. Lots of new actors in the film. There's a lot of Vaiva Harsha, the YouTube sensation. He has a really, really good role in the film. There's Padma, there's Abhinav and Posani sir. There is Zabardast Venu. So lot of actors, lot of popular actors from Telugu cinema in the film. And of course, there's Rama Rao sir, who has a really important, and he also has a love track in the film. And the hero has a love track with Posani sir. So there's a lot of confusion happening in the film. I really took my time to sort of take up another Telugu film, and I just wanted to make sure that this time I get it right, because I didn't really bag a lot of the kind of roles that I got post Gunde Jari. I wasn't really happy. They were all, you know, in a similar zone, which is not the problem, but they were all second leads and ensemble casts, and I think I was looking more for a solo lead. So I think a lot of credit goes to the director, because he gave me the opportunity to be a part of it. And the team is really, really fresh in terms of the DOP, Vishweshwar sir. He's, it's his first or second film, the director's second film, the hero's second film. It's my second film. So a lot of second timers, lots of newcomers. So it was fun. It was really good fun. I mean, we had, you know, it was more like friends on set, and we were just chilling. We didn't really feel like we were shooting as such. So lots of fun times, and we shot the songs in Bangkok, and and we did like 3 songs in 6 days. So I as a girl, I died changing my clothes and hair and makeup and shoes and jewelry and, you know, everything. Every small thing has to be looked into. So, but we sailed through it, and we had lots of fun. It's a girl next door. It's not like serious cinema happening here. It's a fun rom-com. You come, enjoy it, chill with your family entertainer. So come with your families, enjoy it, watch it, have fun. Got some offers in Telugu, so hopefully soon. And apart from that, I've had 2 releases in Malayalam this month, God's Own Country being one of them, and Bangalore Days by Anjali Menon, which is, yes, feels really good. Language, like I've always said, it hasn't been a barrier, because moving to South wasn't a conscious choice. It happened, and I'm really glad it happened. It's sort of becoming a trend, girls coming here and going back, but I really like working here, and I hope I get lots of work here.
You have a dream actor or director you
want to work with after this film? Always tricky to take names, but I really like Mahesh Babu. I think I've seen some of, I've seen Okru and I've seen some of his other films, and I think he's a really good looking and talented actor to work with. Of course, then there is Bunny, who is the fantabulous dancer. I couldn't believe it. And I was like, oh my God, he's so good. And then Ram Charan, who's also come to Hindi and now he's back here. So I think lots of good looking heroes to work with in Telugu. I think Rajamouli, sir. I watched Iga and I think it's a really brilliant concept. It's really out of the box. So it's not like that, but it has to be a really important role. And but what I was getting wasn't really as important. Wasn't a substantial role. See, Gundechari was also on paper a much bigger role. You know, on paper it was a much bigger role, and it I had another song and things like that. But in the process, things changed, which is why I've been a little apprehensive about second lead. Yeah. I think we're done, no? Let's have chai. Let's watch the film tomorrow. Hopefully, you all will like the film. And you all will have good things to say about it. Not really, yeah. I mean... There's really not been... you know, in getting the dialogues right and getting the lip sync right, that has been priority. So I hope I've got that right, because I think it's really putting off when you watch an actor and you can't even get the lip sync right. So I've really worked hard on that aspect of it. But otherwise, it's a really simple character. There's nothing. I can understand a lot more, but this is only my second film and I'm coming almost after many, many months. So if I spend some time here and do more films, I'll definitely learn. Yeah. It's all simultaneous and it's all happening. Yes. No, I think it's mostly the stark differences, budgets. Telugu is, of course, a much bigger industry and a much more colorful industry than Malayalam is more script oriented, and you know, Telugu is more like your commercial cinema. Tamil, I've just done one film, which was an out-and-out commercial, so I think they're pretty much similar, but Malayalam is a little different. Also, my roles have been very different, you know. I've played a Muslim girl, I've played a post-woman. I've been paired opposite Mamukka in a period film, so they've been really different kind of roles. So I think there's less scope to experiment in Hindi, Tamil and Telugu, and little more in Malayalam. Yeah, but this is really... Yeah, I think this is a good space too. This is what the audience really enjoys, and this is what they come and pay monies for, you know, for entertainment. So I think that's, So it's fun to be part of these films. Telugu, actually, for me, it's the easiest in terms of understanding it, because it's a little less complicated and it's closer to... As in, there's a lot of Sanskrit, if I'm not... Yeah, there's a lot of Sanskrit, so it's easier for me to understand. And hopefully I will be able to pick it up soon. Right. Because, and also, right, it's constantly... and they speak so fast that it's really difficult to comprehend. It is, and that was my first film. So when you start with the toughest, everything else seems okay after that. It's one of the toughest languages in India. So I'm okay. Andriki namaskaram. Yeah, that's the easiest. You know, I wish I had that choice. As a newcomer, Well, I'm 9 films old, so yeah, I don't know. But it's only my second Telugu film, so you won't really, I won't be considered a newcomer. I've been working for 2 years, but it's always a good space, because as a newcomer, I understand that one is and I still am very unsure of, you know, sometimes very unsure of the way to do a scene and things like that. It's only after years of practice that you get the hang of it. So it's nice. You're trying to figure things. You're not really like, okay, this is the way to do it and let's do it. You know what I mean? So it's nice, fun. You're trying to figure out things on set and you're discussing constantly how to go about things. I think that sort of always brings out new things when you discuss them much more. And I look like Katrina, really? I have no idea. You should ask my mother or my father.